Damascus experience with Jesus, he was determined that come what may, he was going to serve God and he was going to talk about who God is. And so now that's where God has us. We have to be in a place where we are willing to lay down our life. We are willing to give up everything that we have. Sometimes in our history, we know that we've been broken. We know that there's things that come our way that make us feel like we're less than who we are. But we got to be willing to take what's left in our life and use what God has remained in us so that we can serve him and he can use us. Sometimes we got to be like Paul. And Paul, what Paul did was, wherever he went, regardless of who believed him or who was on his side, he was determined he was going to serve God and give the word of God. That's why we have to give the word of God. We got to not just give the word of God. We got to know the word of God in our heart. David said it like this, thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against you. We can't say what the word of God is if we don't know what the word of God is. It's just not enough for us to come into the presence of the Lord and sit in the pew Sunday after Sunday. We've got to check what we've got left. I know sometimes people say, you don't know my history. You don't know how I've been stoned. You don't know how people have talked about me. You don't know how people have put me to the back burner. You don't know how I've been broken. My heart's been broken. My life has been broken. You don't know about the ancestral stuff that I've gone through. You don't know about how people have molested me. You don't know about the things that I've gone through. But Paul went through more than that because he was ostracized by the church, the very people that said they love God. Now they put him out and said, we don't want to have anything to do with him. And so Paul is finding himself having to ask for it to go to the court of Caesar. And if anybody knew anything about Caesar, they knew that Caesar was a hater of everything. Caesar didn't mind killing you. Caesar didn't mind having you fed to the lions. Caesar didn't mind having you crucified. But Paul found himself at the mercy of this barbaric person, this barbaric king that didn't even care anything about him. So now we can look at our lives and wonder what we've gone through that he hasn't gone through. It's nothing to be compared. The Bible says he was whipped, he was thrown asunder, he was left for dead. But he continued to serve God. He continued to preach the word of God. He continued to love God. He continued to go about his walk with Jesus Christ, which is where God wants us at in this hour in our life. That we're going to meet some people that don't know God. We're going to meet some people who's never heard of Jesus. We're going to meet some people that have been homosexual, that are lesbians. We're going to meet some drug addicts and some drug users. We're going to meet some people who's been abused. We're going to meet some people that have gone through a whole lot of things in our life. But what we got to do, what God has commissioned us to do, because we got the Holy Ghost, we got to grab a hold of that little bit of that Holy Ghost that we have inside of us, and we got to trust God that he's not only going to take us to it, but he's going to take us through what we got to go through. He's going to be with us. He's going to strengthen us. He's going to be the one that's going to give us wisdom and knowledge and understanding so that we can be the person that he would have us to be. We got to stop walking around talking about scripture that I can do all things through Christ who strengthened us, and then we don't do anything through Christ who strengthened us. We got to stop walking around quoting the scriptures about I belong to God and I'm victorious and I've got the Holy Ghost rest ruling abide inside of me, and then he's going to lead me and guide me, and then we want to allow him to lead us and guide us. What we got to do is grab a hold of that little thing. Jesus said, if you got faith the size of a grain of mustard seed, you ain't got to have but a little faith. And no matter what you've been through, it don't matter how you got there. All that matters is that you believe that what the word of God says. And all that matters is that you stand on God's word, which says that I can do all things, which says that I am more than a conqueror, which says that the Holy Ghost abides inside of me, and he is going to lead and guide me. The Bible said, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. Not just blessed, not just happy, but everywhere they go, every ground that they tread on, it's going to be blessed for them. And so now, because the Bible said, greater is he that's on the inside of you, then that means that Jesus is rest ruling and abiding inside of you. Anything that Jesus has done, you are able to do also. That all you got to do is grab a hold of that little thing that you have, that little bit of faith that you have, just a little bit. It doesn't take much, but when you take that little faith and you mix it with grace, you take that little faith and you mix it with the word of God, you can be more than a conqueror. You can have peace that surpasses all understanding. What we got to learn how to do in the midst of the storm. And Paul, they had got caught up in a storm. It said they got caught up in the storm called Euroclydon, which is like a hurricane. And we've seen the effects of a hurricane in these last few months, how devastating they are, how they tear up everything, and how the waters begin to flood, and how the wind blow things off and down. And so they were caught up in the midst of the storm. And sometimes in our life, we gonna feel like we are caught up in that storm. We gonna believe that we are in the midst and the wind is blowing around us. But we got to have an anchor in the Lord. We got to grab a hold of ourselves. We got to grab a hold of the Lord himself. We got to trust that God will never leave us and in no wise forsake us. We got to believe what God says concerning him. The Bible says God's promises are yea and amen. That means that if he says something, it's got to come to pass. He said he's not a man that he shall lie, neither is he the son of man that he shall repent. That means that if he made you a promise, it's got to come to pass. If he said it, you can believe it. Grab a hold of that.
Hallelujah.
Jesus told the people, he said, have faith in God. That means have faith and trust in God's faithfulness, because we already know we're not going to be faithful. But if we trust in God's faithfulness, which is we trust in what God says, we can do anything that we want. We can do anything that we set our mind to do. We can do anything that God commissioned us to do. And what Paul did was, in the midst of all the people that was around him, because the thing about it was, Paul was with other prisoners, but Paul hadn't done anything. Paul was innocent. Sometimes we are innocent and we are missed the things that's going on. And we feel like we got to defend ourselves. But we got to learn how to do like Paul did. Only thing Paul did was he began to pray to the Lord. Because he knew God had everything in control. We got to start learning how to pray more and talk less. The Bible said pray without ceasing. We got to pray like Paul did in the midst of the storm. And while everybody else was being fearful, Paul was calling his God. And he was praying to God. And God in return was talking to Paul and giving Paul's instructions. Sometimes we're in the midst of people and ain't nobody saved but us. Don't nobody there know the Lord but us. And so while they are worrying, but the Bible says to be anxious for nothing. While they are worrying, we can be praying and talking to God. We can have faith in knowing that our God is in control. That he's leading God. And though while it looks like it's one thing, it's not what it looks like. Because while we walk by faith, we don't walk by sight. So it's not what it looked like, it's what it doesn't look like. So while it looked like it's a storm, actually there's peace in the storm. Can't you remember what Jesus told the people on the boat? He said to them, oh ye of little faith. And he turned and looked at the waves and said, peace be still. He commanded them. The Bible tells us that greater things that Jesus did, we ought to be able to do them also. What we got to do is trust that what he said concerning us is going to happen. We might be broken, and our lives are broken. Our families are broken. Our hearts are broken. Our relationship is broken. We are broke up. But while we are broken in the natural, we are whole in the spiritual. Which is why we need to stay in the realm of where the spirit world is actually there, where God actually exists. Because the Bible tells us that God is a spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Meaning you got to know truth if you're going to worship him in truth. Meaning if you're going to know truth, you got to know who Jesus is. And so if we walk in truth and walk in the light as Jesus is the light, we're going to have fellowship one with another. Not just with the people on the earth around. We're going to have fellowship with Jesus himself. Now we got somebody in the midst of the storm that's going to say for us, peace be still. So we find that Paul, if you go to verse 27, we see that Paul said, but when the 14th night was come, as we were driven up and down in Andrea about midnight, the shipmen deemed that they drew near to some country. Sometimes we're going to go through some places and we ain't going to know where we're at. We're not going to know where we are. We're not going to know what to do. We're not going to even know what to pray. But the Bible says we don't have to know what to pray because the Spirit will pray for us. That's why we got to have the Holy Ghost. So that we'll have something to pray for us. Someone to pray. We might not have mom and them to pray for. Maybe mom and them can't pray. Maybe they don't know God. But we got to have the Holy Ghost, someone to pray for us. So now, it tells us right here that they was in some country, didn't know where they was at. And sometimes we find out we're in a place where we don't know where we're at. But it said, and they sounded, they made a sound. Sometimes we got to get on our knees and we don't know what to say. But the Holy Ghost began to speak it with utterance. They began to speak it in our language that we don't know what it's talking about. Because first of all, he ain't talking to us. Because if he was going to talk to us, that means we know what to pray. So because we don't know what to pray, and he began to speak for us and speak in a new tongue, God that's a part of him is going to tell him and going to lead and guide him. Because how many ever been in a situation when you find yourself and you don't know how you got there, let alone how to get away from there? And sometimes you can't say nothing, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. I don't know how I got here. I don't know how to get away from here. I don't even know what to pray for this. But when you get on your knees and you begin to call on the Lord, and the Holy Ghost began to speak. And the Holy Ghost began to speak with that heavenly language. And he takes control. And then the things that you don't know what to say, he began to speak to God concerning them. And as he speaks to God concerning them, God began to move ahead of you. So that when you get to the place where you need to be, God is already there and has already worked it out. So now all you got to do is say, thank you, Lord, not because of anything that you've done, but because of everything that God himself has done. And so it says right here, it says, then fearing lest we should have fallen upon rocks, they cast 4 anchors out on the stern and wished for the day. You know, sometimes in the wee hours of the night, and you ain't got nobody else around to keep you happy. Sometimes you go through things on the day hours, and you plaster this smile on your face because you want everybody around you to think that you got it right and you're doing it right. But inside you are tore up. Inside there's nothing but turmoil. Inside you is nothing but confusion. Inside you there's nothing but hurt. Inside you there's nothing but pain. And so when night falls, you don't want to go and be alone, but you got no other choice because now God got you right where he wants you to be. So now when you go in and you close the door and now you can't have a smile on your face because there's nobody in there to see that fake smile on your face. Now you can let the tears fall. Now you can cry out to God. If it's no more than say, help Lord. Now you can say, God, here I am. Now you can be truthful to who you are. Now you can be real for who you are. Lord, I can't get it right. Lord God, I'm in a storm. I don't know what to do. Lord God, I know if I make the wrong mistake, I can mess up completely. My life will be destroyed. Not just my life, but somebody that's connected to me, their life is going to be destroyed also. Lord, I don't want to go through this because if I mess up, how is it going to look to the church? How is it going to look to my family? How is my children going to look at me? And God can fix it right there in the midst of the storm. You don't have to worry about hitting your toe up against nothing, because God going to go before you and make easy your way. He's going to make the rugged places. He's going to make them smooth and the crooked places. He's already going before you to make them straight. You don't have to worry about having to talk to no mountain, because he's going to bring down the mountains. But you got to go in and you got to go through the storm in order for God to bring you to where he wants you to be. And listen to this right here. It says, Paul said to the centurions and to the soldiers, except these abide in the ship, ye cannot be saved. Then the soldiers cut off the ropes of the boat and let her fall off. Sometimes we got to listen to somebody else besides ourselves. Sometimes we got so much pride. Sometimes we think we know everything. Sometimes we think we are Jesus' baby brother or Jesus' twin. Sometimes we want to change our name to Christ. We want to change our name to El Shaddai because we think we got it all right. We got all the answers. We know what to do. But if you had been there, there would have been no need for God to send a Savior to the world. Sometimes we got to pray. away this pride. Because it ain't supposed to be about us. It's supposed to be about God. And so God will bring us to some situations and some circumstances that only He can bring us out of. But it's already working for our good. And so God, what God will do is He'll send somebody to give us a word. He'll send somebody to give us a scripture. Sometimes He'll put a commercial in the Bible with Balaam and Balaam. And God had to speak through the donkey, the most unlikely person. Now the soldiers, because they was on a mission and doing their job, they humbled themselves because they had fear too. And they listened to Paul, because the one thing they recognized about Paul was Paul had a relationship with his God. And that's what we got. We got to have that relationship with our God. And so let's go. It says in verse 40. And when they had taken up the anchors, they committed themselves unto the sea. We got to commit ourselves to something that's bigger than us. We got to commit ourselves to the Lord Jesus Christ. We got to surrender to Him. We got to forget about how big we are and how strong we are and how important we are and what our status is. We got to commit ourselves to Jesus, because He's much bigger than we are. And it says, and loose the rudder bands and hoist up the mainsail unto the wind and made towards shore. Sometimes we got to surrender to God and just let Him carry us in the direction He wants us to go. We got to be led by the Holy Ghost. We got to allow Him to lead us and guide us. That's what Jesus said was. He said, when the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, He shall teach you. He shall lead you. He shall guide you. Because we've never been this way before. We've never been saved before. And it said, and fall into a place where two seas met. They ran the ship aground, and the forepart stuck fast. Sometimes we get stuck right where we at, don't know which way to go. And remain unmovable. Can't move. Shouldn't move. Should not move. Need to stay right there until God tells us what to do. But the hinder part was broken with the violence of the wind. Sometimes what's going on with us, it'll mess us up real bad. But we got to stay right there. And then we go down to verse 44, which is where I want to go. And the rest, some on boards, some on broken pieces of the ship. And so it came to pass, they escaped all safe to land. We all supposed to have the same focus in mind, which is getting to heaven. Some of us, we don't know how we're going to get there, because we go through so much and our faith may not be where it should be or where God wanted to be. But one thing we can do and have faith and hope in this. If God said it, we can take it to the bank. If we got enough faith to believe that He said, when the Spirit of God rests ruling by, if that Spirit would dwell in Jesus Himself, if it dwells inside of us, when the trump shall sound, we gonna be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. The dead in Christ is gonna get up first, and we which are alive and remain, we gonna be caught up to meet Him in the air. We don't have to worry about what's gonna happen next, because we gonna reign with the Lord one day in glory. We don't have to worry about being sick no more. We don't have to worry about bills no more. We don't have to worry about who's talking about us no more. We don't have to worry about drugs no more. We don't have to worry about anything else. We don't have to worry about the neighbors. We don't have to worry about the president. We don't have to worry about wars. We don't have to worry about rumors of wars. We don't have to worry about earthquakes and downward places. We don't have to worry about the enemy. We don't have to worry about our money being short. We don't have to worry about who's talking about us. We don't have to worry about what the doctor says. We don't have to worry about what the law says. Because we know that where we are going, we're going to walk on that road that paved with gold. We're going to be in a place, if we are sick, we can just reach up on the tree and take a bite, and our bodies are going to be healed. We don't have to worry about anything else. All we got to do is worry about being ready when the king comes. All we got to do is worry about, Lord, what else do you want me to do? All we need to worry about is, Lord, my desire is to please you. All we got to worry about, Lord, if you say it's not so, it's not so. All we got to do is grab a hold of that little bit of faith, that little bit of grace, that little bit of love, that little bit of joy, that little bit of peace, that little bit of Christ. Just grab a hold of it and trust God that if he bring us to the storm, in the storm there's a lot of things going on. In that storm, there may not even be shelter. But I read in the word of God that he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. I read in the word of God that God said he would be my shepherd. What the shepherd did was, when there was a storm, when the weather was bad and things was going wrong, the shepherd would just take the sheep to a safe place. Oh, God is good, people. We've got to learn how to be committed. We've got to surrender our life to him. Because whether we want to believe it or not, the Lord is so soon to come. I believe he's standing right there, and the angel is standing beside him with his lips on the trumpet, waiting for the sign, waiting for the sign, just waiting for the signal from the Lord. Go ahead and blow the trumpet. Go ahead and blow the trumpet. Go ahead and make it known to my people that you don't have to worry no more. You don't have to worry about this old world anymore. You don't have to worry about the enemy on your trail anymore. You don't have to worry about who is and who isn't anymore, because I'm getting ready to come back. I'm getting ready to come back. And the word of God said he's coming back for a church, not just any church. He's not coming back for Refuge Church of our Lord Jesus Christ in Henderson. He's not coming back for Church of our Lord Jesus Christ in Oxford. He's not coming back for Presbyterian Church. He's not coming back for the Catholic Church. He is coming back for his church, the church triumphant. And if we just hold on a little bit longer, church. Just hold on just a little bit longer. Jesus. Hold on to your faith. Hold on to that word that God sends your way. Hold on to it. And if you just hold on, you're going to make it with that little. Let's stand on our feet.